हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज। ओके, नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट, इन टुडेज क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज सम इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज, विच इज व्हाट? ट्रायंगल and its property. We discuss about the very important chapter of your NCERT exercise, which is what? Triangle and its property. This is very important chapter for you and okay examinations. Now dear students, first of all we discuss about the some important properties related to triangle is what? First, dear student, we discuss about the angle sum property of the triangle. And you know that, dear student, in any triangle ABC, in any triangle ABC, the sum of all interior angle of a triangle is 180. Means, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, this is one of the most important property of triangle. Means the interior angle. The sum of all interior angle of a triangle is equal to what? 180 degree. Now, dear students, so here this is angle A, angle B, angle C. So sum of all these angles is equal to what? 180 degree. Now, we discuss about the exterior angle property. Exterior angles property of a triangle. Dear student, according to that property, suppose that if we draw a triangle ABC and its side BC produce to suppose that D. Okay, dear students, if suppose that we produce its side BC through D, then the angle ACD form a what? Exterior angle. So here, and the exterior angle, this is the what? Exterior angle. And exterior angle as ACD is equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle. Means from figure exterior angle ACD is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle. Means angle A plus angle B. This is other most important property of triangle. This is the angle sum property of the triangle. Okay, this is the exterior angle property of a triangle. Now, dear friends, we take some important question of your NCERT exercise based on that property. Let's see. And we take a question, which is what? Find the values of x and y. Let's see the question. Find the values of x and y in the following figures. Okay, find the values of x and y in the following figures. And your figures is, let's see, first figure is, this is suppose A, B, C, D, E, okay, and this is AT, this is Y, this is 50 degree, this is X, this is your first figure. And this is the second figure is what? Let's see, the second one is what? Yes. This is A, B, C and its side BC produced to X. Sum D, this is X, Y 50, 60. Y 50, 60 degree, okay? Now let's see. In that question, dear student, we find the values of x and y. Okay. Now, for that question, dear student, first of all, what I do? Now we take and solve the first part of this question. Let's see. Solve first question. In that question, first of all, we know that when two lines are intersect each other at any point, then the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. So in that figure, here y and 80, these are vertically opposite angle. These are what? These are vertically opposite angle, and the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. Yes. So we know that, right, in this way, we know that the vertically opposite angles are equal to each other, that is angle y is equal to angle EAD, that is y is equal to, this is what, 80 degree. This is the first answer. Okay, now we find the angle y. Now in triangle ABC, we apply the angle sum property of the triangle. Okay, now in triangle ABC, applying the angle sum property of the triangle, which is what? The sum of all interior angle of a triangle is 180. So x plus y plus 50 is equal to what? 180 degree. Now we put the value of y. So we get what? X plus the value of y is what? 80 degree plus 50 is equal to 180. Okay, now so x plus this is 085, 130 is equal to 180. Okay, now thus the value of x is what? 180 minus 130 is equal to what? The value of 180 minus 130 is what? 50. Okay, so the value of x is what? 50 degree. So this is the another answer. Okay, thus dear student, in this way you can solve that type of question. Okay, applying the angle sum property of the triangle. Now similarly we take and solve the next part of this question. Let's see. Now, we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see. Dear student, in that question, we find the value of x and y. So, first of all, in triangle ABC, we apply the angle sum property. Let's see. First, in triangle ABC, okay? In triangle ABC, using angle sum property of a triangle, that is what is the property? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C each equal to what? Sorry, sum of all these angles equal to what? 180 degree. So now we put angle A as what? 50 degree. Angle B as what? This is y. Angle C is what? This is 60 is equal to 180. Now we get y plus 110 is equal to 180. Thus the value of y is what? 180, transfer that side, minus 110 na? Yes. Now the value of y is what? 180 minus 110, we get what? 70 degree. Thus the value of y is what, dear students? 70 degree. This is our required solution of the given question. So in this way we find the value of y. Now dear students, what I do now, we also find the what? The value of x. Now for the value of x, let's see. For the value of x, let's see. Here angle x and angle y form a linear pair which we discuss in the class lines and angles. We already discussed about that topic. The linear and the sum of angle in linear pair is what? 180. So here the x plus y is what? 180 na? So x plus y is equal to what? 180. We already find the value of y. So here we put the value of y. So x plus 70 is equal to 80. Thus the value of x is what? 180 plus 70, transfer that side, minus 70. So we get x is equal to what? 180 minus 70 is what? The value of 180 minus 70, that is 110 degree. Thus the value of x is 110. Thus dear students, in this way you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on the topic angle sum property of the triangle and exterior angle. Now we discuss some important question based on the exterior angle property of the triangle. Exterior angle property of the triangle, we take one question based on that topic. Let's see. Now find the value of x in the figure. Okay, let's see. Find the value of x in the following figures. In the following figures, first one is what? This is x 70, this is x, this is 100. Okay, and in second figure is what? Second figure is what? This is 90 degree, this is x, and this is what? 125 degree. This is what? 125 degree. Now where we solve first part of this question. Dear student, you know that, just I discussed about that, related to exterior angle property of a triangle, ki exterior angle is always equal to sum of its two opposite interior angles. So in first question, dear student, this is the exterior angle, and exterior angle is equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle. So now let A, B, C and D. So from figure, exterior angle CBD is equal to sum of its two opposite interior angle, means angle A plus angle C. Na? Now we put each and every value. Now angle CBD is what? 100. Angle A is what? 70. Angle C is what? X. Now from there we find the value of x as 100 minus 70, that is what? 30 degree. So this is the first answer of this question. The value of x is what? 30 degree. Similarly, we can solve the second part of this question. Let's see. We take as angle A, B and C and D. Now here we know that also exterior angle here, which is the exterior angle? Angle BAD. So exterior angle BAD is equal to sum of its two opposite interior, means angle B plus angle C. And from figure, angle C is what? Right angle, and means 90 degree. Angle C is what? Right angle is always equal to 90 degree. So here we put, this is 125 is equal to angle B is what? X. Angle C is what? 90. Thus the value of x is what? 125 minus 90. So we get what? 35 degree. 35. This is the another answer. Okay. Thus dear students, in this way we discuss the topic interior angle property of the triangle and exterior angle property of the triangle. Now you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on this property. Now dear student, we are going to discuss about the sum of the length of two sides of a triangle. Okay, now let's see. Now we discuss about the property sum of the lengths of two sides of a triangle. Now we discuss about the sum of the lengths of two sides of a triangle. Dear students, according to that property, suppose that we draw a triangle ABC. Okay, now for triangle ABC, dear students, the sum of the length of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. It means that if we take AB plus BC is always greater than the third side as AC. Similarly, if we take AC plus BC and AC plus BC is always greater than AB. Okay, and if we take AB plus AC is always greater than what, dear student? BC. So it means that this is one of the most important property of a triangle, ki sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. Okay, so this is very important question. So using that concept, you can solve so many question of all the question of your important NCERT exercise based on that topic. Okay, so you can solve. So please remember that property, which is very important for you and your examination purpose. Now we are going to discuss about the right angle triangle and Pythagoras property. Okay, let's see. Now we discuss about the right angled right angled triangles and Pythagoras property. Okay, this is one of the most important property and triangle of your syllabus. First of all, we discuss about what is the concept of a right angle triangle. Dear student, a triangle in which one angle is 90 degrees. Okay, a triangle in which one angle is 90 degrees is called a right angle triangle. Like, take an example. Suppose that ABC. Okay, dear friend, this is a right angle triangle. Right angle at B means in that figure, angle B is equal to what? 90 degrees. So this is a what? A right angle triangle. This is what? A right angle triangle. Okay, and Pythagoras property is always using regarding to right angle triangle. Okay, not all the types of triangle. That property always for use for a right angle triangle. Now let's see. Dear friend, in any right angle triangle, AC is known as your hypotenuse, the side BC is known as the base, and the height as AB is known as the perpendicular. Okay, and according to Pythagoras property, according to Pythagoras property, the square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of base and its perpendicular, means base square plus perpendicular square. Now from figure, hypotenuse is AC square is equal to base is what? BC square, BP is means perpendicular is what? As AB square. So this is one of the most important property, okay, of your syllabus. Thus, dear student, in this way, using all the important concept of right angle triangle and the Pythagoras property, you can solve so many questions of your NCERT exercise. Now, dear student, we take and solve some important questions based on that property. Let's see. We take a question based on this property. And our question is what? Let's see. ABC is a triangle, right angle at C. ABC is a triangle. Okay. Right angled at C. Right angled at C. If AB is equal to, if AB is equal to 25 centimeter, okay, and AC is equal to 7 centimeter, find BC. Now let's see its solution. Here ABC is a right angle triangle, right angled at C. Okay, if AB is equal to this, now first of all we draw a triangle, right angle triangle, let's see. Now we draw a triangle in this way. Here ABC is a right angle triangle, right angled at C. It means that angle C must be equal to 90 degree. This angle is equal to what? 90 degree. This is the concept of this question. And in that question, so the side AB is given as what? 25 centimeters. And here the side AB is what? The hypotenuse, which is equal to what? 25 centimeters. Hypotenuse is equal to what? 25 centimeters. And AC, side AC is given as what? Which is the perpendicular of your this question, which is what? 7 centimeter. Here the side AC is what? 7 centimeter. Okay, we find BC, and BC your base of the triangle, okay, which is find that. Okay, dear students, now in that question, dear student, using which property? Using Pythagoras property. Okay, now we know that by using the Pythagoras property, what? Hypotenuse square is equal to what? Base square plus perpendicular square. Now we put the value of its hypotenuse is AB, so AB square is equal to base is what? BC. So BC square plus perpendicular is what? AC. So we write AC square. So we find BC now. So the value of BC square is what? AB square minus AC square. So we get what? The value of AB is what? 25. So we write what? 25 square, okay, minus AC is what? 7. So we write 7 square in this way. Now we have BC square is equal to 25 square is what? 625 minus 7 is 9. So we get what? Let's see. 625 and 14 90 by minus 6. 576. Okay. Now, so BC square to what? Square root 576, and we know that the square root of 576 is what? The square root of 576 is what? 24. So this is what? 24 centimeter. Okay. So in this way, this is our required solution of the given question. Thus, dear student, in this way, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on the topic right angle triangle and Pythagoras property. Okay, now, dear students, we take one more question based on of your NCERT chapter. Let's see, exercise. And let's see, find the perimeter of the rectangle. Find the perimeter of the rectangle. Find the perimeter of the rectangle whose length is 40. Whose length is 40 centimeter. And the diagonal is diagonal is 41 centimeter. Okay, this is the one of the most important question. So first of all, you know that perimeter is length into breadth, and each now in rectangle each angle is 90 degree. Okay, suppose that ABCD is a rectangle, and now we draw its one of its diagonal AC. And the length is given as L is what? This is 40 centimeter, and the one diagonal is given as 41 centimeter. So this is a right angle triangle. So this is hypotenuse, this is base, this is perpendicular. So first of all, we find the breadth of the rectangle. Now let's see its solution. In triangle ABC, we get what? AC square means hypotenuse square is equal to base square means AB square plus BC square means breadth. So AC is what? Diagonal. So 141 square, this is length, this is 40 square, this is breadth. So we write B square. So we get what? B square is equal to 41 into 41, 1681 minus 1600. Okay, thus the value of B is this is 81. Thus the value of B is under root 81 means 9 centimeter. In this way, dear student, the breadth of the rectangle is what? 9 centimeter. Breadth of the rectangle is what? 9 centimeter. Now its perimeter will be what? 2 into length plus breadth. This is the formula for the perimeter of rectangle. So we get what? 2 into L is what? This is 40. Breadth is what? 9. So we get 2 into 49. So we get what? 2 9s are 18. Carry 1. 2 4s are 8. 1. 98 centimeter. Because of, you know that the perimeter is always in what? Centimeter. Perimeter is always in centimeter. Okay, and area is always in square unit. Now, thus, dear students, in this way, in today's class, we take and revise a very important chapter of your NCERT exercise, which is triangle and its property, and we discuss all the important topic which are included in your chapter. Okay, now, dear students, in this way, you revise all the questions. Okay, you revise all the question, all the topic which we discuss in that class and in also previous classes, and now complete your NCERT exercise. Okay, now in next class, we take and revise some other important chapter of your NCERT exercise. Okay, dear students, so first you solve all the questions which we discuss in that class also, and
in your NCERT exercise. Now in next class we take and revise some other chapter of your NCERT exercise. Now thanks to all.